grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, I welcome you to the Supreme Mass for our brother Fran. We gather to pray for his soul and to pray for the family as they mourn his loss. In the moment of baptism, Francis died in the bosom of Christ. May he now be found with Christ. And may he hear the words of everlasting life. Come, Lord, and share the joy of my Father.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. For everything there is a season, and for every matter under the heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up what is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, time to cast away stones, and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to seek, and a time to lose, a time to keep, and a time to cast away, a time to rend, and a time to sow, a time to keep silent, and a time to speak, a time to love, and a time to hate, a time for war, and a time for peace. God has made everything beautiful in his time. Also, he has put eternity into man's mind, yet so he cannot find out what God has done from the beginning to the end. The word of the Lord.
Thanks.
Thank you. guides me along right paths for the sake of his name. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff comfort me. You set a table before me in front of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Indeed, goodness and mercy will pursue me all the days of my life. I will dwell in the house of the Lord for endless days. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you, and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. You receive it. There is a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time for everything under the heavens. This morning we find both a time for tears and a time for joy. First, we come together to mourn the loss of our brother Fran, a husband, father, grandfather, and a friend. But as we mourn, we also know that we have plenty to celebrate. First, we give thanks and celebrate the gift of life that Fran was given. And second, we celebrate and pray for the gift of eternal life. Is actually the most important thing that we do here this morning. We pray for the soul of our brother. There is a time to mourn and a time to laugh. For Fran, there was a time for everything under the sun. A time for children and a time for grandchildren. Fran loved his wife Marlene, and he loved his wife Karen. He loved his kids, and he adored his grandkids. For Fran, there was always time for family. A time for sports and a time for the nights. Fran enjoyed sports, whether it was playing them or watching his favorite Minnesota sports team. Fran was also active in his church and the Knights of Columbus and in men's club. You can actually trace this activity in the church all the way back to when he was a boy. He was an altar server. He was always proud of his Polish heritage and his Catholic faith. It was a time for Texas and a time for Minnesota. In his retirement, Fran liked to winter in Texas. He also loved his time in Minnesota during the summer, working at the golf course at Oak Glen, spending time in his cabin, or just being in his garden. For Fran, there was a time for everything under the heavens, and ultimately, a time to be born and a time to die. Family chose the Beatitudes for our gospel this morning, where we hear things like, "Blessed are the meek, for they words like meek, we might think of somebody weak or soft or even wimpy. But of course, that's not what the Lord is talking about. The Lord is speaking about humility. And to be humble isn't to be cowering, but rather it's to put others first, put others ahead of ourselves. Someone once said that humility isn't thinking less of yourself, rather it's thinking of yourself a little bit less, instead of thinking of others. Fran was described to me as someone who's humble. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Fran was an honest man in his words, his actions, and his conduct. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. This last one is for us. Jesus wants us to entrust Fran to him, knowing that the Lord can love him more than we could ever imagine. And at the same time, to put our trust in the Father. Because of God's great love for us, we are people of hope. We are people of the resurrection. Because of our Lord's victory over sin and death, eternal life is a possibility for each of us. And we take comfort in that. Our gospel ends today with Jesus saying, "Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." It's one last reminder that we are called to pray that Fran might receive his reward, that he might be given the gift of eternal life. To stand, brothers and sisters, as we continue with our prayers this morning, we present our petitions to our Heavenly Father. For Francis, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our brother, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he may be raised on the last day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our brother Francis, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, we humbly ask that you hear these prayers. We offer them on behalf of your servant Francis. And as always, we offer them in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is risen and who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
You be seated for the preparation of the gifts. that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Francis, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the name of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. For the Eucharistic prayer, I invite you to either kneel or be seated. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the sacred passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with this Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Michael, with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, at Please confirm in faith and charity your building church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Bernard, our Bishop, and his assistant, your bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Francis, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with your Son and a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. When from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you in their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Again, by chance, you shall be seated. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by our brother Francis, may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death in itself. And may our prayers for Francis rise like incense.
Thank you.
want you to have that are on the ramp on the way down, so you're each invited to pick one of those up. But then a reminder of what I've already talked about communion, in just a second I will come down. We'll start with the front pews. If you receive, if you're Catholic, or if you're not Catholic or not prepared to receive communion, you can request a blessing by crossing your arms over your chest. Either way, whether you receive or not, Anne will then move the procession with the urn out, so front rows follow Anne out, and so on throughout the back of the church. So the burial is for the family, so they're grateful. The rest of you came here to pray with us and to remember Francis. So we will prepare for Holy Communion.
I just want to make sure.